Hi, hello students, welcome to SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. If you are not yet subscribed, kindly subscribe to our channel, and if you want to further develop this channel and want to contribute to my lessons, you can contribute to your will, friends, because someone may be rich and money may not be a matter, someone may be poor. So I'm providing free classes so that those who get benefited, you can donate for further development of our education channel. My friends, today we're gonna see about polity. Whatever the polity in the syllabus that I'm gonna deal in this session or in this course, I'll be explaining this class because this is an introduction class to polity. So you'll be seeing in clear introduction of the polity, and also I'm at started different courses regarding environment geography and modern history and modern India and also the ancient history. So you keep subscribe to our channel and keep watching. I'll be providing more interesting things to you, my dear friends. This is me, SP Rajan, alias SPR, here on this education channel. If you want to watch something interesting or any topics you need, you can go to playlist and kindly watch the important topics and these things, my dear friends, because I'm only the person working on it, so it may take time, and also I'll be working hard with your supports, because increasing supports make me more strength, and so I'll be teaching more, my dear friends. Here all the topics will be dealt by me in Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English, so kindly subscribe and support me, my dear friends, so that I'll be bringing more interesting things. Now we shall see what are all the topics that I'm gonna deal in this course. From now I'll be going a bit slow, my dear friends, because here you must learn what is the things you're gonna learn in history, not history, polity. If you're gonna study polity, you need to know also the history. The interlinking between the history and polity is important, my dear friend, because the polity is not a sudden thing that had happened in India. It has rather evolved through our history. So from the history of British steps had provided to our modern day polity, what are all the British steps provided to us, the things we'll be seeing in the further classes, my dear friends. We'll be seeing Regulating Act 1773, Peace India Act 1784, Charter Act and all the Charter Acts here, and Government of India Act 1858, what are all given in it, Indian Councils Act, Indian Council Act 1892, Indian Council Act 1909, Indian Government of India Act 1919, and again Simon Commission's what it had done, and Communal Award what it is, and Government of India Act 1935, India Independence Act 1947, Constituent Assembly how it had been formed, and composition of Constituent Assembly and committees of Constituent Assembly, Constitution how it had been started, and preamble. From that, what are all the elements of preamble and importance of the preamble, everything will be dealing. And next, Union and its territories, and Commission on State and Formations, Citizenship, Acquisitions of Citizenship, Citizenship How Act 1955, and how a person's citizenship can be taken away, and fundamental rights that had been provided to us by the Constitution, and what are all the characteristics of fundamental rights. And next, Article 12 in the state, and Article 13, Equality, Right to Equality, Articles 14 to 15, and next, Right to Freedom of 19 and 22 articles, and next, Right Against Exploitation 23 and 24, and Right to Freedom of Religious Activity articles from 25 to Article 28, and Cultural and Educational Rights Article 29 and 30, and rights that not applicable to the foreign nationals. What are all the rights that are applicable only to the citizens of India, and what are applicable to foreign nationals? And Right to Constitutional Remedies, which is Article 32. And next, we shall come to DPSP, Directive Principles of State Policy, which state must make according to the governance of its government. Article 37 to 51 will be provided there. And Fundamental Duties from Part 4A, which had been newly added, Article 51A. And next, here we see the President and his functions and how he can be impeached. Then Vice President and all the details of him, and how the election rules of President and Vice President work, and what are all the purpose of Council of Ministers, and in detail an Attorney General of India, duties of Prime Minister, Parliament, readjustment of each census during House of Parliament, and also qualifications of a memberships of Parliament, special address to Government, President, and next, Officers of Parliament, who are all the officers in the Parliament to be present, and what are all the business in Parliament to be carried away, disqualifications of a member of a Parliament, how a member of a Parliament can be disqualified, and powers, privileges, immunities of Parliaments and its members. See, if you are in a Parliament, you have certain privileges, immunities and powers. What are all those things that you're gonna deal? You'll be seeing in this. And legislative procedure. If you're gonna pass a bill, what are all the procedures that you're gonna pass the bill? That things will be dealt here. And procedure of financial matters. What about the finance and money related matters will be dealt here. and money bill, everything will be going on over this topic. Next, procedure of a parliament, how a parliament is functioning and what are all the procedures to be taken for a bill and procedures in the parliament. And next, legislative powers of a president. Next, Supreme Court will be seeing in detail, and Controller and Auditor General. Next, the Governor, what is his functions, what is it differentiates him from the President. Council of Minister of States, and next, what are the state related ministers. And next, Advocate General, he is the law, highest law member of a government. And next, a conduct of a government business on state. And next, state legislature, officers of state legislature, business of state legislature and these things. And next, disqualifications of members of state legislatures will be seen. Then legislative procedures of a state, assent to the bill in a state legislature, how in a state legislature a bill will be getting its assent, the procedure that it goes through, those things will be dealing in clear. Next, a procedure in a financial matters in state legislature. And next, procedure of state legislature of a state. Legislative power of a governor, what are all the power of a governor in the state legislature. And next, we shall be comparing with the presidential power also. And then the high courts in the states, subordinate courts present in it. And next, a union territories, a panchayat raj system, how it was been introduced as part 9, and municipalities of part 9A. And next, we come to the schedule and tribal areas, part 10, legislative relations between a union and states. What are all the relations and stakes between a union and its states will be provided. Next, administrative relations between a union and its states. And financial commissions, what is finance commissions, borrowing, how do you borrow, how, what is the deficit, budget deficit, everything will become not budget deficit but simple borrowings. Trade, commerce, intercourse in the territory of India, public service commissions, tribunals, elections, National Commission for Scheduled Caste, the National Commission for Scheduled Tribes, also the language of a union, emergency provisions and part 19, and then amendment of constitution of part 20. These are all the things that I'm gonna deal, my dear friends, around 94 topics. I'll be subdividing into the classes, so it may be dependent, but I cannot assure that how it may be provided. But thing is that I'm working on it and making all the classes most probable, my dear friends, because increasing supports make me more happy and I can make more videos. I'm also not concentrating on these views and these things, my dear friends. If I help one student, that's more than enough. So you can donate me for the help and for the growth of my channel, and also you can be part of our channel, because this initiative I'm gonna reach all the poor kids and rural students, because I'm also from the same rural background working on the teaching field, my dear friends, because I want to become the best teacher ever. So my hard work, you support me, you, I'll be working for your betterment on all the things, and also more interesting topics will be dealing, my dear friends. So kindly share with your friends, also subscribe. See, if you are subscribed, one other day if I get a good internet in my village, I'll be coming live. So if I come live, I'll finish all the topics as soon as possible. So explaining is not a big deal for me, but thing is that keep subscribed so that only you can know when I'm gonna take classes, so you won't miss our topics. And now we shall go into the polity. Before going into polity, you must know the modern Indian history. In the modern Indian history, you study starting phase of modern Indian history, then come to the polity, then only you will be feeling much easier to learn. If not, it will be difficult, my dear friend, because it is an interrelated topic. See here, you know that after 1764 Battle of Plassey, the power of the states, which means a regional provinces, has been gone to the whose ruled British company, which means it is not a British directly ruled, a East India Company started ruling our nation. So if this East India Company had introduced a dual rule, dual government, that is by Robert Clive had introduced dual government. So this ideology was really annoying and many people suffered, and there is no any betterment of the people. Complete exploitation was a high significance. So the government has formed a first proper government has been formed through the Regulating Act. So first Governor General is that, see, important facts is in the Regulating Act 1773, the important fact is that the first Governor General is Warren Hastings. He was a Governor General of Bengal. So the rule started from Bengal, and here we shall see what are all the significance and this thing from the top to bottom here, my dear friends. The significance of Regulating Act 1773 is, what is its significance? British decided to regulate a East India Company. Before that, East India Company doesn't have any government, but it was involved in all the political and administrative activities of India. So they were involving directly and indirectly. There's no direct impact, which means they will be indirectly exploiting and also influencing the rulers over there, but there is no proper and legal rule by British. So British started a regulating East India Company. So they demarcated the political and administrative functions of the company. So the now company's functions is being further divided as some functions to be given as political and also the some functions to be given as administration. So the demarcation of the company functions has been laid down, and also they also found laid the foundation. See, until now there is no any single administration in India. So they led to the foundation of central administration in India. You can observe that because they had been like provincially conquered and ruling, because Madras has been separate province, and also Bombay, and also we can see this Calcutta. So they were differentially, you can see Marathas has been conquered, and all these things you will be seeing in a modern India. So these things has been conquered by them as separately and has been included, but there is no any central administration. But after this regulating act, they had brought a central administration, because from this central one decision, it will be followed from the other rulers or other provinces also. Here, what are all the features that had been provided in the regulating act 1773? We shall see that Governor of Bengal was designated as Governor General of Bengal. Until that, they used to call him as just a Governor of Bengal. Now he had become a Governor General. The General is the name extraly added after Regulating Act, and also the Governor of Bombay, Madras, everyone has been become subordinate to Governor General of Bengal. So obviously he has been the lead most power, and others has been subordinated to him. And next, the Executive Council. See, the functions of a administrative must be carried out from Executive Council. Those Executive Council has a 4 members, which means a government decision must be made by this Executive Council. So he must consult that Executive Council and make that decision. So that it had a 4-member council, and it is assisted by Governor General. So Governor General is the person who assisted it. And also next we shall see the officers were prohibited from private trade. You can see this, there was an issue going on in modern Indian history. I would have said that the dastaks was a big issue. So if such issues has been going on, to that overcome that issues, it had prohibited the officers or members of East India Company involving in private trade. So they must be, everything must be carried out legally. These are all the decisions that has been taken from the Regulating Act 1773. And also one more thing, a strong thing is that 1774 they had built a first Supreme Court in India. That is to Supreme Court first started established in Calcutta, my dear friend. So it had a 1 Chief Justice and 3 judges. It had a 4 members, 1 is Chief Justice and also 3 judges. It had begun its function in Fort Williams around 1774 in Calcutta, my dear friend. But this, one more thing you must be remembering, this Supreme Court is not functioning, okay, taking care of any problems related to Indians or Indian people. This Supreme Court has been started in Calcutta just to favor a British administration, which means there are illegal corruption and this thing, many wrongdoings have been going on in British East India Company. So to judgment them or to punish them or to make them right, the Supreme Court has been established. But in time frame, it had been slowly converted to favor Indians, and also Indians has been included. Those things will be seeing in further details, my dear friends. This is all about Regulating Act, how the political administration has been laid down and started in this Regulating Act. And also 1764, I said what about a dual government and these things, that I had been explained in the modern India sessions that I have been provided. So kindly watch it, my dear friend. Now we move on a Pitt's India Act 1784. See, this 1773 they introduced a Regulating Act 1773, but thing is that why did they introduce this again Pitt's India Act? One more thing, my dear friend, you know Magna Carta. Magna Carta is the main parliamentary book form of parliamentary form of government started in British. This is the beginning of a parliamentary form of government, that is to mean British. So it had been around 800 years back this has been started, my dear friends. According to this, British doesn't have any fixed constitution. They used to change the constitution every 20 years. So remember this, their rule is 2020. Okay, they used to play 2020 match. Like that you remember. So this 2020 rule, British always have every 20 years, their constitution will be rewritten. Which means they'll be adding the according to the time frame, or according to the era, and according to the modernization, advancement, they'll make changes, my dear friend. So these are all the things, important things of Magna Carta. So that only, whatever the acts British have been passed, you can see 1773 they passed, again 1793 they had passed, again 1813 they had passed, and again you can see 1833, and also again 1853. See, whatever the acts and these things you see, you can see a gap of 20 years, but certain times it will be in between, like Pitt's India Act. Why this Pitt India Act has been in between of these 20 years means, see, if any dire importance is there and any important changes must be made, that time they pass any imminent, which means in between some laws and acts, my dear friend, that is the thing here. But mostly it is a procedurally running a constitution of British. So this you can find 2020 rule. Or if you even forget what are all the Charters Act or this Government of India Act or any Councils Act, a regulating act, you don't fear, you just remember this 2020 rule and remember all the charters and this thing act, so that only numbers remembering is not a big deal to you. And next, if you come to the features, if you come to the features of the Pitt's India Act, it demarcated the political and commercial functions of the company. See, before they had said that a political and administration functions of the company only, but now the commercial functions and political functions has been separated. See, before all the administration, political and also commercial business, everything is dealt from one source of company, but now you separate it. Political functions must be separate and also the commercial functions must be separate. That has been decided in this Pitt's India Act. And also for the commercial affairs, which means the business of the company, is carried or managed by court of directors. Whoever has a deal or whoever has his share in the company, he can become the court of directors based on the share and investment, these things. So the commercial details or commercial managements or commercial affairs of the company is managed by court of directors, and political affairs, whatever the political functions of the company, is carried out by board of control. So now they had divided in the Pitt's India Act two things, which means court of directors and again a board of control. These two things has been started or introduced in Pitt's India Act 1784, and also they introduced board of control can supervise the operations of government and revenue. See, the board of control has two functions. They also operation or supervise what are all the functions government is doing, and also they take care of revenue system also. And next, British government got a complete control of company affairs. See, whatever the company affairs, whatever the things the company is taking care of and how they are earning money, everything had got under the British control. There is a story for these things also, my dear friend, but here in these classes you won't feel that much interesting in hearing stories, so I would skip it. But also even direct classes stories will be good enough. Now we shall see here 1833 Charter Act. Okay, I said it's 1813, there is a one more Charter Act. No, I missed over it. Here, 1813, there is a Charter Act. What did they do? They abolished the monopoly of East India Company. See, East India Company monopoly has been abolished. Now, East India only, before that, only East India Company can trade with in India. But after 1813 Act, not only East India Company, any company from British can come and trade in India. So, and also, this monopoly is not abolished for two things in 1813 Act. These things have been dealt in modern India classes. So what are all the two things is opium trade plus and also this tea trade with China and trade tea. These things has been not abolished in 1813 Act, my dear friend, except these things, everything has been abolished. And next, if you come here, they had provided 1 lakh loan to the development of the educations, and many things are taken in 1813 Act, my dear friend. And now we come to the Charter Act 1833. Here the future is that a Governor General of Bengal was designated as Governor General of India. Now, until now, 1833, all the persons who have been Governor General, they had been called as Governor General of Bengal. After this, they had been converted or again now called as Governor General of India, which means whole India has been taken under control. Now, Bombay and Madras presidencies has lost their legislative powers. Now Bombay and Madras, they can't make any legislative actions. So everything has come under the control of Governor General of India, who works from the Calcutta. And next, Governor General got a complete control of civil and military affairs. See here, all the civil affairs and military affairs, everything had been got under the control of this Governor General of India. And next, a law member was being added and as the fourth member to the Governor General Council. Actually, this Governor General Council had been started, you can see here, my friends, in the starting in 1773 Act, they had introduced four member General Council. Governor General Council. Here you can see 4 member General Council, but after this Fits India Act 1784, they introduced, wait a minute, I will erase it. Okay, in 1784 they had made 3 member Governor Council. Because it is not present over here, they had reduced it to 3 members, but now in 1833 Act they had add one more member as law member to the Governor General Council. This is the changes that they had made. And next, if you come, a law commission was constituted. This is the first law commission to be formed, that to be in Charter Act 1833. The laws were made by these acts and named as acts. From here they were regulations. Here before that, and the whatever the laws or these things made, they called it as regulations, but now it is called as act. So the changes they made to the law is been called as acts. And also East India Company also ended the commercial activities and also had begun a high level of administrative body. From now the East India Company is completely concentrating on administration of India, then only they can have whole control of the nation. That was their plan. And next important facts, if you see, the first Governor General of India is Lord William Bentinck, and they tried to fail to open competitions of civil services. Okay, they tried to open which means they had planned to start civil services, but that has been failed. Okay, you know that these steps they won't ask. And these are all the things that had been made in 1833 Act. Okay, my dear friends, thank you. Thanks for watching SPV Education World. Together we create a better world. Subscribe to our channel and also contribute to our channels for the further development and everything. It's me, SP Rajan, alias SPR, taking for you classes in Tamil, Telugu, Hindi, English. Also, those who had subscribed, kindly thank you for subscribing and viewing, my dear friends. Also, watch our playlist for further details and anything you need, because in playlist I had created a separate courses in detail for you, whatever the things you learn. Okay, this is me, SP Rajan, signing off. Kindly inform more friends, my dear friends. In future, I'll come up with more interesting classes in Polity. Okay, bye, take care.